Hello, Mallards! It is Friday, and I finally have a Megan at Montverde. But I'm excited because this is Megan's first time coming to Shakespeare here, and they do their Shakespeare out in the wild. So it's gonna be fun. We're making our way out to the theater. Look at us go.
Look at that bear.
A winter's tale.
The thing I know about it is there's a bear.
I read the show a long time ago. We can talk about what I know in a minute. But look at this absolutely, oh, look at this stunning person and a fun stage.
It's intermission.
It is intermission.
And the set is now on fire and it really jump scared Mallory.
It did jump scare me. I did not expect it to be on actual fire, okay? I mean, we're outside, so that is, you know, the beauty of it. But like, I still didn't expect it to be on actual fire. I'll show you in a little bit. The first half, I was going to say act, but it's definitely not just one act because this is Shakespeare.
It's split into part one and part two in the program. So part one
is over. Part one is the tragedy. So we're going to get into the comedy.
Although
now,
I think that the first act had a lot more levity than maybe some other people directed as. Mm-hmm. And maybe that lends to it being more fitting with act two. We'll see
how it plays out,
but I enjoyed
the main conclusion. If you haven't seen The Winter's Tale, here's your too long didn't read. Boys are dumb.
Mm-hmm. And bears are hungry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the entirety of the first part. Boys are dumb and bears are hungry.
Maddie is the shepherd at the end was a star. Mm-hmm. And I'm ready for more shepherd content, please.
Actually, everybody has been very, very, very good. Sydney did a fantastic job as Camilla, especially in the opening, really bringing everybody in. And she does a great job speaking the Shakespearean language in, I think, a very, like, well-understood way. Mm-hmm. Because it's tough to be the first person who has to, like, convince an audience that you can listen to Shakespeare and understand what's happening. And Alec has been fantastic as the dumb boy, otherwise known as King Leonidas.
Yeah. A really, really digestible Shakespeare. Good direction, I mm-hmm. assume, also.
Yes. Oh, yes.
I like that the king isn't stuffy. I feel like it would be easy to make the king very regal, mm-hmm. and then the first act be not as fun.
Yeah, it was very, very fun. And I have enjoyed the staging too.
Not a lot of winter, but I gotta say. No heavy coats, no snow, nobody's in blankets. Where's the winter?
It could be because we're in Florida and they're doing the show outside. Megan wants everyone to suffer for their art.
Suffer. I want to see you sweat.
Also, a shout out to Elizabeth for Hermione's trial speech. Yeah. So good.
It's good.
So good. We're going to go and enjoy part two. I will show you the set that's on fire. On fire sounds maybe more dramatic than it is.
It's on fire.
Like, this absolutely qualifies as
Oh, it looks
fire.
Less on fire in the video.
It's
going to look like a fool. We swear it's on fire. Look at those basketball hoops.
The show is over. In a similar way to when I was jump scared by the set being on fire, Megan was jump scared by the lights
These
turning
lights
on.
Were really bright, okay?
It's true.
And act two was much more of a comedy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it really was. Very enjoyable.
I think that Amanda doesn't like this show because she has ADHD. Too much happens.
That's fair. Yeah. Sydney had the most costume changes.
So many costumes, and they were all great.
They were all so good. I loved all of Camilla's.
I don't know if it was that Sydney's great or if Camilla's
maybe we just love Camilla.
Probably both.
Yeah, I've decided. Okay, we talked about a show, a Death Day murder mystery that's just all Shakespeare ghosts. But I maybe also want a show that's just the Shakespearean characters who are scheming.
Oh, so like Camilla and Horatio, they'd be great for the pals.
Oh my gosh.
Rosencrantz, really Guildenstern, and Camilla.
Also, Paulina, also a schemer.
Camilla had big, like, daughter in the parent trap situation. Ooh, like, mm-hmm. She wasn't like, I'm scheming. She was like, my friends are fighting, so I'm gonna write them a letter that's a lie. Except the letter is a person.
Yeah.
It was a human child.
Yeah, it really did have that vibe. It was really fun. A lot of, like, the plot in, I can't, you're right. The plot in the second act is a little bit hard to follow.
And in the first one, too, there's just a lot of plot. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so there's a lot to follow, and I totally understand why people struggle with it. But I think that it is really fun. But we were discussing favorite moments from the story of Act 2. I love, so it is discovered that the king's daughter, like, was a shepherdess, and then she falls in love with the prince of the other kingdom, and then they come back. And there is a moment where he, like, meets the prince and the daughter.
He could have recognized her.
Yeah, but he doesn't recognize her in that scene.
I feel like Shakespeare was like, the audience already knows that it's his daughter.
Yeah, so I don't need to tell them.
So we don't need to tell them.
So he doesn't recognize her then, but he's like, no, don't worry, I'll talk to your dad. And then he's like, oh, your dad is coming. Oh, everybody's coming. We do not see any of them arrive. That is not on stage. It is just
finding out.
It's not on stage. But there is a moment where one of the servants comes out and goes, oh my God, you really, I mean, obviously in Shakespeare, you really should have seen when the king arrived. And then the shepherd showed up, and then they were holding on to Hermione's, like, cloth, and then it revealed that this is their daughter, and wow, it was so incredible.
We should have seen it all. We should have.
If you have FOMO, this show is not for you. because you're really missing out.
Mallory, it's a winter's tale, not a winter's show.
Oh, okay, I see. So
we're telling people what happened, not showing them.
I will say that Act 2 has way more Tyler, and that is a gift to all of us.
And a little dance that looks like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But in Tyler.
and that was a gift to all of us.
Truly. It,
very, very, very fun. Great job with, we didn't talk about this, but I liked the curtains.
Oh, the curtains were fun.
Mm-hmm.
The curtains were fun.
Yeah.
I liked them opening, I liked them closing. I liked sometimes they clearly were supposed to be opening, and they weren't, because it's opening night.
Mm-hmm. Shout out to Tyler for getting dragged off stage with the curtains.
Oh.
Very dynamic.
Oh. Impressive.
Mm-hmm.
I hope you're okay.
Yeah. Overall, very enjoyable. Good tech, good performances, fantastic direction. We had a blast. And there are still 2 more days, so you can come see the show. Bring bug spray.
Oh my God.
And I'll see you tomorrow.
Ooh, they're going out.
Oh. Nice. Woo! We're cheering for you.
No longer on fire.
Woo! Also, it's not a big stick.
That was terrifying.
It's just you having to get on it.
That's
yeah.
A lot of work.
We're impressed. Yeah.